50's was a wonderful time for great music. We had, as you say, sock hops, and we went to St. Mike's, and we went to De La Salle, and of course the boys came to our gym as well to dance. And when they came to our school, of course, the nuns were always there. Mother Saint Dorothy or somebody would be up in the balcony there and making sure that we weren't too close. And if we did get too close, the nuns would come and touch us and just say, "You're dancing a little bit too close." And then we'd always end singing Mother Beloved. And we'd all have to turn around at the, I guess, 11 o'clock on the Friday night or whatever, and we'd all turn around and they'd have a spotlight on the statue of Our Lady. And we all sang Mother Beloved. And we also sang, we sing of Notre Dame. It was a lot of fun. Rosary Sunday, and it was in October, because October 7th. Is Rosary month. And so I'm going to say the second Sunday in October, all the Catholic high schools used to go down to the grandstand at the exhibition, and we would parade around on the ground. And if I'm not mistaken, it was the girls from St. Joseph's themselves that made the crucifix or something, but the rest of us all became part of the rosary, and we would all parade around, and then we would go and sit in the grandstand itself. And then I think the girls of St. Joseph's would just do the regular rosary, like the 10 beads in each decade. And that was a big day for us, because it was, you know, St. Joseph's and Loretto and the long crinolines, and we wore saddle shoes and white bucks, and we used to wear our sweaters, kitten sweaters, and we used to wear them buttoned up at the back. Why, I don't know. But that was the style. We also had penny loafers and the white shoes, white bucks, as I say, and we had the socks. And also, we used to wear what they call Carhartt jeans. And you used to roll up the hem, and we put in those great big pins in them. Now, these pins that you could wear in your kilt. And this is when, before we wore kilts, but I mean, that was actually a kilt pin that we would wear on the outside hem of the Carhartt jeans. And we also had what they called brotherhood jackets. And brotherhood jackets were like a navy blue denim. Now, I found out, much to my dismay, that I was not supposed to wear it at school. With my school uniform, I was not supposed to wear my brotherhood jacket with my nickname on the back of it. Stephanie called me aside and one time and said that I was not allowed to wear that with my school uniform. So I didn't anymore, but that was another thing. We also had ponytails and the ducktail haircuts, and the guys that used to dippity-doo and all that stuff that they used to wear in their hair. And with the fawns, when you see pictures of the fawns, how they used to have that, you know, the hair that went back and the stuff that went down, and then all kinds of gel. And as the girls, we had dippity-doo, and that was what the girls used to put in their hair to keep it back. And then you keep your kiss curls. If you wore kiss curls, then you had to have some kind of a gel to hold a kiss curl. And ponytails, I say, and crinolines. Oh my goodness, the more you had, the better. So you could walk down, you sat down, as soon as you sit down, your dress came up. If you had one of those crinolines that, you know, went like that. I was not allowed to sit in the front seat in the car, because when I sat down, up came the skirt and the driver couldn't see. So I had to sit in the back when I wore a skirt with big sleeves. Also, in the 50s, we got to go to the Maple Leaf Gardens. One of the girls, her father was involved in politics for the area that the high school was in. And we got special tickets to go and watch the not NHL, but before that. And so we got to see St. Mike's play and the Marlies play. So we got to see like Tim Horton and all those guys before they really got up there. I mean, I saw like Carl Brewer and Dick Duff, Les and Dick Duff, and all the young kids before they went on to the Maple Leafs or they went on to Boston or any of those guys. So we got to go Sunday afternoon, after Mass, of course. I go to Maple Leaf Gardens and we got, I'm going to say, the Blues. And they were $2 a ticket. And of course, we dressed up in those days. And then when you used to, we would be at that position where you could look over when they were coming off the rink or off the ice. And of course, they'd look up to you and they had no teeth. A lot of them didn't have any teeth. They were broken noses. They were bashed and battered. So we used to wait afterwards for them to come out of their dressing rooms. And they would come out, and of course, they got their teeth in, and they've got, you know, bruises are all fixed up, and they've got, you know, ties and suits and stuff on. And so we got to chit-chat with all those guys in those days, you know. This was before. But in the 50s, we used to have rock and roll concerts down at Maple Leaf Gardens. And we had the Platters, and we had all kinds of the big stars in those days, the four aces, the four whatevers. And they were wonderful. And I think we could get tickets maybe for a couple of dollars. Also, oh, yeah. In the 50s.
Diamonds came.
Now, I don't know how that was arranged, but I have a feeling that one of the girls that went to school knew somebody who knew somebody. And they happened to be in Toronto at that time. So they came and they sang and they were on stage in the auditorium. And of course, you can imagine 300 or whatever of us in those days screaming. Well, we weren't as nuts as they go now because all the nuns were around. So, I mean, we sang along and clapped along and of course we knew their music, so we sang along with them. But for us 15 and 16 year olds to have, you know, the top, one of the top quartets in those days, to come to our school, that was really something. So it was fun. And they, as I say, they must have sang a cappella because I don't remember them having any instruments or anything. So I think they did a lot, they just did their music a cappella. Mm. Unless there was somebody playing if there was somebody playing music, I didn't see because we just focused on these four guys, you know. Anyway, so that was wonderful. And as I told you, we also had the jukebox in the basement, which was just outside the cafeteria. And at noon hour, we'd put our nickels in and played all the music of the 50s. And we danced in the hallway outside of the cafeteria. After lunch, we would go down and then we'd have, and of course they did the slosh and we had
stroll.
We did the stroll. So there would be a whole line of us in the corridor downstairs and we would do the stroll. And I mean, of course that would take up the rest of the lunch hour, you know.